We have talked a lot lately about the unemployed, people who would love to have a job, but the story is for some of you who have a job but aren't loving it. So whether you're underemployed or just unhappy where you are, in tonight's Project Economy Report, News Force John Eby found some tips on how to go from the job you have to the job you want.
Even before the economy went south, low job satisfaction was the subject of conversation, surveys, even TV comedy. The recession only added to the problem, forcing some workers into underemployment, settling for part-time jobs because they're the only thing available. But Keith Lusher, an author, speaker, and marketing expert, says even if your job is inadequate, it's still an asset.
Make sure that where you are today, by the time you leave, you will have left your mark.
And that's his first tip for getting a better job. Make your mark where you work. The best way to do that, he says, is look for a need.
Be open-minded about what kind of needs can your skills fulfill.
He says whether you're a banker or a barista, the key is to think like you're an entrepreneur.
Whether it is increasing efficiency, saving money, increasing profits, increasing revenues, something that's measurable.
The next tip is to remember you're writing your resume every day and avoid a trap for discouraged workers.
We've all gone into places where we could tell that person doesn't like working there and they're taking it out on us. Don't be one of those.
Lusher says no matter what kind of job you have or what kind of job you're looking for, what employers are searching for above all else is hard work and integrity. It means a little bit less of this and probably a lot more of this.
That's the question your next employer is going to ask. They're going to ask you, what did you do? What kind of benefit did you provide? What kind of impact did you have?
But even if you are owning your job, sometimes it's your friends that get you the break. That's why Lusher says prospecting is huge.
Prospecting is defined as the continuous activity of exploring for and qualifying new people to meet and talk with about what you do and your business.
Also known as networking, prospecting is nothing new, but the tools are. Websites like Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn especially.
LinkedIn really has, in many respects, is replacing the traditional resume.
But he says, remember, prospecting is a two-way street.
Hey, Michael, it's John. I was wondering if you could do me a big favor. Would you mind writing me a recommendation on LinkedIn?
John who?
John Eby.
Oh, yeah, sure, anytime.
All right, thanks. You're the man.
Yeah, bye now.
Score. But our expert actually says I'm doing my reputation an even bigger favor if I return the favor.
By all means, contribute. Pay it forward.
And his last tip applies to communication, online or not. Listen.
Put your personal agenda aside.
He says listening opens doors, building the relationships that will lead to opportunities.
When you can make that emotional connection with another person, that makes all the difference in the world.
The difference that could get you a better job.
And that was John Eby reporting. And if you missed some of those tips or want to hear them again, we've posted the story on our website, wyff4.com.